Hi and welcome to Space with Sarah. Today I'll answer some of your questions again. And lately a lot of people have been asking me about the upcoming solar eclipse on August 21st. So first of all, a solar eclipse happens when the sun, moon, and earth are perfectly aligned, and you'll actually be able to see a full solar eclipse roughly once every 18 months here on Earth. And when I was a kid back in 1999 in Denmark, I was actually lucky enough to see a total solar eclipse, and it's very, very amazing, so you should definitely do it if you have the chance. The reason an eclipse is even possible is because the apparent size of the moon is the same as the apparent size of the sun. And this is actually a coincidence because the sun is a lot larger than the moon, but it's also a lot further away. One of my favorite experiments with a solar eclipse was back in 1919, where Eddington used a total solar eclipse to prove Einstein's theory of general relativity. And what he did was he measured the bending of the light from background stars around the sun's mass during a total eclipse. Pretty cool, huh? Okay, now let's move on to some of your video questions. This first question is by Raphael, who's asking whether or not supermassive black holes in the center of galaxies can actually be formed by smaller black holes merging. And you're definitely right that this is one of the theories of how very massive black holes form. And we actually still don't know exactly how these supermassive black holes can become so massive so early in the history of the universe. But one theory for it is exactly what you're saying, that very early on, stars exploded and these left behind black holes that eventually merged and grew to the larger black holes we're seeing now. And continuously, these keep growing even today. This next question is by Damien, who's asking where life fits into the history of the universe. So I've talked about this a little bit in a previous episode of Space with Sarah, where I explained that you have to wait a while for something like Earth to actually form. But it turns out this can happen only billions of years after the Big Bang. Another part of your question is asking about radiation, and you're definitely right. In the early universe, the whole universe was actually dominated by radiation. Then it moved into a phase of being dominated by matter and dark matter, and now we're actually living in a phase where dark energy is dominating. So you can definitely start to think about where life fits into all of this, and we definitely do not have all the answers for that yet. This next question is from the Cimbrian Bull, who wants to know how the heat death of the universe ties in with an expanding universe. And you're right that these two things tie together very nicely. It definitely does look like our universe is expanding and asymptotically reaching a uniform state. And I'll go a lot more into thermodynamics and entropy in a future video, but one other fun fact I wanted to explain to you here is that it doesn't only seem like the universe is expanding, but it also seems like we're running out of hydrogen to make new stars. So we're definitely moving towards a universe that's a lot darker. Okay, everyone, thanks for watching, and don't forget to check out the eclipse. But protect your eyes! Uh-oh, but you can't really see anything with these on.